Yes.
Quick show of hands, how many people have dated someone who could be considered evil? Nice. Some of you fucking perfectionists out there. I like your dating history. You didn't raise your hand, I like it. This song, you won't understand this song. Yeah, you can listen, but you won't, it will, yeah, you. This song is about someone who's the kind of person where it's a Sunday and you're sleeping in and you're running your fingers through their hair and you're like, ah, what the fuck? And then there's devil horns. You guys remember The Little Mermaid? Do you remember every couple of years Disney comes under fire because people watch the DVD and they say, there's a scene, the castle is a castle, and then in the next frame it's a penis. And then in the next frame it's a castle again. This is a conspiracy. Disney sucks. Happens every couple years. They sell a shit ton of Little Mermaid DVDs because everybody wants to see the penis. And they're like, the animators maybe were bored. I don't think so, but that could have happened. And so I always thought Under the Sea, right? That song with the crab. You know that one?
Under the Sea.
Don't make me go into it. Don't make me get my Sebastian on so early in the evening. I can do it, but we gotta go later into the night. So, I always thought that was a pretty subversive song. Like, that was a dirty song written by perverted people. And then forced upon children by a talking crab. Sample of lyrics, right? Under the sea, darling, it's better. Down it's wetter. Take it from me. Under the sea, see, see. Sung to you again by a fucking crab. That's not some fucked up sexual transmitted disease-y shit. Some poor nerdy animator was like, I'll get back at her. The songwriter dude, it's like, fuck my wife. I'll show you. So I wrote this song as like this is a sequel. Where the nerdy dude that wrote the song, right, is like, has come to terms with the fact that his girlfriend maybe, or maybe he, or someone, there's crabs in the relationship there. And they don't come from a fucking toilet seat, I'm just being honest. So I wrote this, I hope there's no young people present. Can anyone look around them, and if there's someone very short that looks maybe six, just tell me, raise your hand. Uh-oh, you're pointing, that's not a good sign. Angry parents. Anyone upstairs? Okay, good. You're pointing, but I don't know, that looks like just a young... Oh, that looks like a child. Okay. I'm gonna speak in metaphor from here on out. Run fast for your mother, fast for your father. Run for your children, your sisters and brothers. Leave all your love and your loving behind. You can't carry it with you. You wanna survive. Dog days are over. Dog days are done. Can you hear the horses? Cause maybe a day come. Oh, sweet Michigan. We always want to figure out Detroit Rock City by Kiss. But we can't. And so I'm going to write one. Pontiac. Pontiac, the place that rock detonates. Yeah, that's a long title, but it's going to be in parentheses. I'm saying like
this kid's dead. This kid's gone.
I should announce this song as if I were in an 80s hair metal band. And I've been doing it too sort of like, been doing too much like a pussy. I need to rock it out a little. So here we go. Which I don't understand, because the term pussy is a terrible term, right? It's like a wimp. But the vagina is possibly the best and strongest thing. If you've ever seen a baby born as a woman, powerful. The uterus, the vulva, the vagina, the whole thing is magical. And possibly way tougher than any guy. Or guy punk. So I'd like to retract that statement. And I'd like to say, I kind of intro'd this song a little bit like a penis. Because if you think about it, penises are pretty fragile little pieces of work. One quick swipe and you're fucking out the window on that guy. So anyway, sorry, young child. What am I doing? I pointed the kid out of a young kid, and then I'm just like, what's up, vagina? Let's sing this song, shall we? Let's sing this for the vagina. Put your hands together. For the greatness that is the lady parts. You guys, gotta love it. It's a fantastic situation. As a dude, I'm at a disadvantage.